Well, everybody would love to have the yard and garden that's the envy of the neighborhood. And every month, Perry joins us from Classic Landscapes and Ella's Gift and Garden with some great tips and tricks. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Lots of color with you today. We've got all kinds of plants here. Let's differentiate, first of all, between shrubs, like perennials, annuals, that type of thing.
Yeah, so typically when we refer to perennials, that's anything that's going to come back year after year. I think we understand that annual is going to be something that only survives our summers. They might be perennial in other locations. We see a lot more of that now, where people see something what we consider maybe exotic or beautiful, and so it's worth taking a risk on, even if we don't know they're going to survive the winters. But generally speaking, perennials are going to come back year after year. Shrubs or woody ornamentals tend to have more of a, if you will, a wood sort of stalk to the shrub, to the plant. Still would leaf out, still come back year after year. Typically are larger, but not always the case. And you know, pruning is a little bit different with them. We're not going to cut them back to the ground the same way we would perennials. You know, an exception might be if you have a cotoneaster hedge or something, it's really struggling, you know, it's older. Those you can cut right back to maybe 6-8 inches from the ground, and they'll actually flush out, rejuvenate over the next couple of years. So you can turn them over that way. But generally speaking, with shrubs, we're going to make some simple pruning decisions, but we're not going to cut them right back like
okay.
We can with perennials.
Well, while we're talking about pruning, is this the season? Is this when we start thinking about pruning them back?
Yeah, I think in a general sense, people are going to start thinking about pruning when stuff doesn't look as good. And we're starting to get into the front of that. You know, the perennials can look a little leggy. Now, you know, selections here that I brought are all obviously in pots still. So I'll say this. If I just planted a new perennial this year, I wouldn't worry about pruning it too much this fall. I'm not going to cut it back. I'm going to let it develop. So really what we're talking about is the principle of pruning. But again, it's for perennials that are growing and taking off. And so, you know, the idea of what you should do now and what you should leave for spring, the fact is, the more you can do now, it'll make for a better spring for you for sure.
Okay, well, show us how to prune then.
Okay, so for a couple things I brought, actually, you can see here, one really popular annual in the fall is actually garden mums. They're really bright, colorful ones that I see just off to your left. They're ones that, when they're looking this good, we're never going to touch them. We're just going to let them grow out. And, you know, when they start to degrade, we can either pull them out of the ground or a lot of times we'll just leave them in pots. And so they're a good example of a really beautiful plant that's going to add some pop and color. You can get them in white, yellow, you know, obviously the orange and sort of maroon, deep red color that I brought here today. Just in front of them are daylilies. They're sort of the grassy looking plant, you know, just right in the front, have a really nice flower. Daylilies you can cut back to the ground. It's really sort of a decision thing. Again, if they're developed and sort of overgrown, you can cut them back. As a general rule of thumb, whenever you've had issues with maybe some fungus or different diseases over the summer, maybe you had some bugs chewing on them, you're going to want to take the leaf litter away. I know you and I have talked composting in the past, and composting is a great idea. But again, if you've had some issues with fungus and stuff, better to dispose of the leaf litter when you cut them. Those, when we talk about cutting back within a few inches of the ground, you don't want to like saw them right off at soil level, leave a little bit. But again, you can take advantage of a beautiful flower, and there's no rush to do that. Now, just in front of them, off the side, is catmint. And catmint can get a little unruly. Like, it's the one sort of a feathery look. It'll really grow quite well all summer long. And so a lot of times you can prune it anytime during the summer. But again, it's a good one to cut back this time of year. The difference with catmint when you have this, you'll probably cut it back about halfway as opposed to cutting it within a few inches of the ground. Again, a good one to cut back. And, you know, it's a great one for helping prevent mosquitoes. So mosquitoes are starting to slow down a little bit this time of year, so we don't have to worry about that so much as well. Now what I have right in front of me is a good example of a smaller plant. This one's a columbine, beautiful, kind of a cool looking different flower. When something's this size, even if it's been established in the garden, I'm not going to play around with cutting this down because you still want some plant to grow there when it's going. And then I have here just off to its right, or my right here, is sedum. And the sedum is actually a great one that's going to flower through September. So you're going to want to allow it, leave it alone. You can cut it back after that, but this is actually going to provide a really nice pink flower in the fall, which we don't see a lot of. And maybe one before we run out of time. You know, this one here that I brought is a coneflower. The coneflower actually has little seed heads that you can see, and they're really effective for winter birds. And so you want to leave them, not cut them back, let the winter birds enjoy them. And again, they'll poke up through the snow and be interesting to look at as well.
All right, we've got to ask you about fertilizing in the fall. I mean, this is the time of year where things aren't going to grow a lot, but should you be fertilizing nonetheless?
Yeah, that's a good question. And a lot of times people think, well, I'm just going to waste the fertilizer. And that's not really the issue. You don't want to fertilize because you're actually going to encourage growth. They need to harden off for winter. What's going to happen is you're going to impact the vitality of the plants with winter dieback and winter kill, and they're not going to look so good in terms of the spring next year. So don't fertilize now. This time of year, you just want to water them through until freeze up, and that'll be it.
What about like hanging baskets and that type? Can you still fertilize those?
Well, hanging baskets are a little bit different because they're annuals. So you're not really worried about them making the winter. So if they're not doing well, you can fertilize them to get a little bit of a flush again, just get a little bit of impact until the hard frost. And you know, some of those plants will survive a hard frost. And other than that,
quick question. I know we're out of time here, but I want to ask you this anyway, because everybody's talking about the leaves changing early. Is it the cold? Is it lack? Is it too much water? What is it that brings the color on early?
Well, actually, what happens is the trees respond first to the decreasing days. People think it's temperature because that's what we respond to.
So it's not the temperature, then.
Not typically, but I mean, whether we're going to see an earlier, heaven forbid, winter, I think is what people are thinking. You're going to get some variation with plants as well, but it's, it responds to the shortening days that you see first. Colder temperatures are part of that, but you know, we'll see how it works out. I'm hoping for a couple of nice months because we need it.
All right, Perry, thanks a lot. For more great details on how to make your yard the showpiece of the neighborhood, you can check out Ellerslie Gift and Garden, located on the corner of Ellerslie Road, Calgary Trail, right across the street from the Classic Landscape Center. More information, 780-988-9888. You can visit them online at either classiclandscapes.com or ellerslieGift.com. They also have a Twitter handle that is featured on your screen. We're back after the break.